As we consecrate, ordain this man, have the role and responsibility to share all good things, encouragement, words of hope, and again share the resources that God has blessed you with. I want to believe this church will increase in offering.
And the church is giving 100,000 shillings per month. How will the pastor live on 1,000 shillings? Shall we be in our mind? Shall we be properly thinking? If we ordain a pastor who cannot even earn the 5,000 shillings,
even somebody
out there is adding a salary to make this family move. Does he require food like any other pastor? Does he require a house like any other pastor? And that's why the Bible has commanded. Share with your teacher.
Shiriki na mwalimu wako.
Every good
vitu vyote vilivyo vizuri.
Amen.
Amen.
I want to believe the Marrakesh people are here.
Ninaamini watu wa Marrakesh.
I want to believe from the next Sunday and continue.
Kuanzia Jumapili ijayo na kuendelea.
They start raising the standard.
Watainua viwango.
The way they give offerings.
Wakati wanatoa matoleo.
The way they pay their tithes.
Wakadila wanapolipa.
Because the purpose of paying tithes and offerings.
Sababu ya kutoa fungu la
mwisho na zaka. The work of the ministry move very fast and very
kusababisha huduma iendelee kwa haraka na kwa kasi.
Because we have encouraged our pastors many times.
Tunahimiza wachungaji wetu mara nyingi.
You should not behave like a beggar.
Usikue kama muombaji.
Or look before people like you are somebody to be sympathized with.
Ati unaonekana kama mtu unahitaji.
When people look at you,
unahimiza
this man may be coming to borrow his money.
Ati huyo anakuja kuombaomba. Akija kwa nyumba yako.
Pastors are not beggars.
And wachungaji sio watu wanaokuja kuomba
usana. You should not have the characteristic of a beggar.
Na hawastahili kuwa na mfano wa.
There are men who have been called to higher calling.
Wameitwa na mwito mkuu.
The higher calling of the of God.
Mwito mkuu wa Mungu.
And therefore those that are being served.
Na wale wanaohudumiwa.
They should also realize.
Wanastahili kutambua.
For them to fulfill their responsibilities.
Ili wao kutimiza majukumu yao.
To increase their offering.
Lazima waongeze matoleo.
They have to increase. They have to tithe faithfully.
Wanastahili watoe fungu la
kweli kwa uaminifu.
Biblia inasema.
Like what the bishop has just said.
Kama yale askofu amesema.
That this church has teachers.
Hii kanisa ina walimu.
Doctors are here.
Ina madaktari hapa.
Oh, nurses are in this church.
Kuna hata wale wasaidizi.
Managers and great farmers are this church.
Hata wale wasimamizi wa.
They can be rational.
Inakosa kuwa na.
They can also rush think proper.
Wanaweza kufikiria mbele.
As a manager,
kama mtu wa kawaida.
As a manager of a new city,
kama msimamizi labda wa.
How much do I need to live?
Na stahili kuishi namna gani?
As a teacher,
kama mwalimu.
What can I? How much do I need to live in my house?
Ninastahili kuwa na fedha
kiasi. And so gives maybe an offering of or maybe 10 shillings.
Na unapotoa sadaka ya shilingi.
You can imagine how much money the church will have.
Then
who, what work is going to be done by the church? We have to change our attitude. Because the problem of our church is not with our people. It's not about the money they have. It's about their thinking. For the Bible says in the book of Proverbs,
Biblia inasema katika Mithali,
verse number 23, chapter 23, verse 7.
23, mstari wa 7.
As he thinks,
as kama vile mtu anavyofikiria.
So,
hivyo ndivyo yeye alivyo.
So our problem is not our money.
Our problem is not our locality. Our problem is our attitude. That's why the Bible all the time calls on us. Changing therefore the way you think. And
instead
of have the mind of Christ. What is the mind of Christ?
It's
the mind of self-sacrifice. It's that mind of voluntary
self.
Praise the name of God. I want to believe we are going to start to continue doing great things, the people of Malakisi.
And I also
believe all of us are going to continue encouraging ourselves. God has called us to serve. And what is this service? Is the mission of the Great Commission. I want to believe from now. We can't have been empowered.
He's
going to be very enthusiastic. After this service, after the anointing that is coming from here, he's going to move in a lot of
zeal.
And open churches almost everywhere. And the members of this church, and all of us. We're going to join him.
That you never could
and make his dream come to pass.
May
God bless you. May God bless you.